Hey, assalamu alaikum. Thank you for joining us here at Mindful Muslimah Speaks. So excited to talk to you guys and to bring the topic of today, because if you can master this topic, you can master a whole lot of other topics, inshallah. So I'm going to give you a little bit of my secret, because I do a lot of things on here and people ask me, how do you do this? How do you do that? And I'm like, there are some mini secrets. So I'm going to kind of bring one out today regarding how to get up at 4:30, even if you don't want to. Now, why would someone get up at 4:30? Well, obviously we're Muslims and we have to pray. So for people who are struggling for fajr, this one's for you. But not just that. What happens if you want to have a better day? You want to have a more productive day, no matter what you were talking about. It could be with work, with school, with kids, with homeschooling. It could be your own personal aspirations. All of these things revolve around the morning. And I have a miracle morning routine that I put in my podcast a couple back. You could check it out. Also have a YouTube video on it so you can see the visuals. You can check it out on my channel, Mindful Muslimah. But how do I actually get myself out of bed to be up and do all those things that make me have such a productive day? Because I'm going to be honest, I do get a lot done in the day. And this was not something I did. I wasn't born that way. It's something I had to condition myself for. But it's not hard, and I'm going to give you my secrets. So inshallah ta'ala, if you stay tuned for this. And if you stay tuned for the end, I'm going to give you my ultimate secret, my life-changing secret, the one that made me wake up for fajr no matter what. And it, subhanAllah, you'd be surprised. It wasn't an ayah of Qur'an, even though the Qur'an is amazing. And it wasn't like a hadith from the Sunnah. It was something else. And that's what I love about what we can bring with this channel, is we can merge kind of modern day trends and ideas and things into our deen and have this modern Muslim way of life, but still holding on to all the tenets of faith, all the basics in the Sunnah without compromising those as well. So I got some secrets. I'm about to bring them out. Stay tuned for us. Inshallah ta'ala, if you do want to keep sending me messages, questions, anything, don't forget. Instagram is the fastest way. Like I said, on my blog, I'm totally revamping it actually right now as we speak, and I'm gonna redesign it, and I'm gonna put up some different documents and books. And like I said, I'm building courses for you guys for like basic stuff, little teeny mini ones, so if you want to work on a particular thing, so no worries, inshallah ta'ala. Okay, diving right in. So let me think. One, two, okay. So we are gonna go through just my couple basic tips and ways that I get up at 4:30 in the morning for fajr and the beginning of my day. I get so much stuff done in this amount of time, and I've spoken about it in my mindful morning routine, because this time, Islamically, we learn that this time has extreme barakah, especially the time right before fajr, right after fajr. And so if you're a mom that's struggling with like your kids wake you up in the morning and it's just like so stressful and you're tired and they're pulling at you and they want breakfast and this and that, and you're just like, your mornings are killing you, and then the rest of your day you're grumpy, and that's totally normal, because if you have a kind of a difficult morning, guys, the rest of the day doesn't go well. If you're young and you just love to sleep and you just keep hitting the snooze button and you're just trying to get up and you're trying to go to school and you're trying to be productive and you're trying to get your papers in or whatever it is you're trying to do, again, this one's for you. And if you're a homeschooling mom that's like wondering why she cannot complete her curriculum, all the stuff she has to do in her day, this one is really going to help you out. This is a life changer. So I really, excited to bring these things to you guys, because these are things that I think are really going to make a difference. So my number one thing I'm going to start to talk about is the obvious one. I have to say it because it's so obvious, but this is the one that kind of messes everyone up. So I'm going to just throw it out there. I know you're not going to want to hear it, but I'm going to say it anyway, because I once, maybe it was you, if you're like this, go to bed early. Stop staying up late. I am a total night person. I was always a night person. I mean, like my whole life, I love the night. I like everybody to go to sleep. They have all this time alone to myself, and I'm staying up and I'm reading or whatever. If you're a person who like binge watches Netflix or YouTube or whatever at that time, whatever it is you're doing, okay, not advocating it, just saying whatever it is you're doing, it's totally stopping you from having a better life. I'm going to be honest. And it's stopping you from being a good Muslim, if you're Muslim listening to this. Why? Because one of the things we have to do is we have to wake up for fajr. It's a fard. It's not optional. How many people wake up for fajr? I'm going to tell you right now, a lot of people don't do it properly. They don't wake up on time. Or if they do pray it, they pray it like super late. Really, really bad, guys. I'm not going to talk about all the Islamic, ramifications of that, but it's totally not acceptable. So if you want to at least get that together, it's really helpful, because when you do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks of you, He gives you more. So honest truth is, we're like upsetting the Creator who's helping us and loving us, and we're making our day harder than it has to be as we take away the barakah. And we also know all the other, you know, hadiths and the Quran and things about this. So in general, usually if you stay up late, you're not waking up for fajr. Even if you're like jilbab, abaya, niqab, big beard, anybody, male or female, it's not happening in the ummah, guys. We have to go to bed early, number one. Number two, if you stay up late, you can't wake up in the morning, and then, like, it's really, really hard to wake up in the morning, period. Even forget about fajr, forget about that. Forget about if you just want to wake up for work, if you just want to get up and do a couple things. So going to bed early makes all the difference. Now, you're going to be like, but that's not fair. That was my time. No worries. We're going to flip it. That's what I did. I used to be a night person. I flipped it to a day person. And inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to tell you how. Keep listening. But I'm telling you that you're just going to literally flip the time you spend from that to that. And you're going to have so much barakah because you're doing what Allah wants. And you're going to find blessing in your day and productivity in your day. Number two, put your phone in another room. Or as far away as you can, that it would be so annoying for you to get up that you're less likely to do so. Why? Because we usually get in bed, and if we do get in bed, we spend it scrolling and tapping for another 30 minutes to an hour, maybe more, who knows, you know. And then sometimes when you wake up in the morning, that's the first thing you're doing for the first 30 minutes to an hour. We're trying to change that habit, also very destructive. If you want to know why you're not being productive, definitely gonna kill it. So I'm just telling you the obvious, but it's also sometimes, guys, the most obvious things are the things that are killing us, and we know them, but we just like, oh inshallah, it's just killing us. So I'm gonna be honest, gotta go to bed early, and you have to do that. Just get the phone away from you. Actually, psychologically, mindfully, mentally, it's even not healthy, to be honest. So getting away is going to help you. And if you've already, like, oh, I put it on my bureau, but you find yourself still getting up, then that's not far away enough. Maybe you need to move it somewhere else. So please try. Number three, this is also really helpful. Make a schedule for your day the night before. If you know what you're going to wake up and do, so much more likely that you're going to do it, because you already have your mind in the mode like, okay, cool, I got to do that right in the morning. Like if I'm going to go to the gym or something, you know, not that I go in the morning, but I'm just saying, I'll put my clothes out already, or I'll put out my notebooks that I'm going to work on, or I'll put on whatever. So I make my schedule and I put my stuff out. Get you trying to wake up early. Mood changers. So that's the other thing. So when you do wake up, you want to be in a good mood. You want to be all like, rah, rah, like, I don't really want to wake up. So what you do is you basically make sure that you start with something that will get your brain in a positive mood. That's why I have journaling. If you go back to my podcast, or if you go to my YouTube again, you'll see I journal. It totally puts you in a positive state of mind. It's so good. But very specific journaling. It's only like 4 points. Again, you can go back and listen how I do that. Also, making morning adhkar or Quran, just 5 minutes, guys. Even if you do it consistently 5 minutes, it's better than leaving it at all. If you can do more, alhamdulillah. The next one is avoid spending your morning responding to people. The morning is for you. You're going to wake up and be excited to spend time on what you want for yourself. The last thing you want to do is spend it helping other people, answering other people, being annoyed by other people. It's also super distracting and usually ruins your morning. So guys, make that time your time. Wake up and do what you want. Create alone time for yourself that you can look forward to, something you love to do, something you know that will make you feel good. And the number one secret to myself getting up early, guys, this was a game changer. And I'm going to throw a name out. And this person, in all honesty, they drop a lot of four-letter words. So I would not suggest you to listen to them. But they do have a book, and the book has no cursing. So inshallah ta'ala, you could buy their book. Or you could just listen to the rule. I didn't particularly buy the book, but the rule enough is enough. The rule is called the 5-second rule. It's by Mel Robbins. If you do this 5-second rule, it's a game changer. I encourage you to go on YouTube, look up Mel Robbins. Again, 4-letter word person, not everything she says is 4 letters, but she is a little spicy. So, but her rule is good. If you want to buy the book, buy the book. It literally requires you to do one thing. It's so easy. When you're waking up in the morning and you're staring at the ceiling and you don't want to get up and the buzzer, you know, whatever, the alarm went off, you just go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and you move. Now you're like, oh, that sounds so, like, whatever, I'm tired, I'm not going to do that. You will, I promise you. Don't have a conversation with yourself. Don't think, don't talk. Don't go, oh, I feel like this. Nothing, just move. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Literally lift your body up, get out. Once I did that, guys, I never, ever had struggling with fajr again. Allahu alam. It is so helpful. So I really hope these tips were helpful for you guys. It's just like a super mini thing just to let you know the secrets to all my productivity is the morning. And if you're struggling with that, this one's for you. May Allah make it easy for you guys. Assalamu alaikum, rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.